people of the internet. It is Tuesday, and this little one and I had some breakfast. Well, I haven't had breakfast yet. I need to get that. and got this one a shower, got me a shower. This one just woke up, little sleepyhead. Yeah, you like to sleep in, don't you? I bought Rev a couple dresses, because I thought they'd just be easiest right now, where like she's holding it when she needs to go to the bathroom, but it's just faster to get her under off in the meantime, when I'm still like a little worried about getting her there quickly. Infant dresses, they don't like have like summer lightweight dresses, really. And if they do, they're super expensive. But all like the toddler sizes are inexpensive. And so they had 12 to 18 month ones, and I got her those. And so they're big on her, obviously, but they work. It's not a big deal. I am feeling much better today, though I think I look pretty tired than I was the day before. Because I told you guys that little Miss Airily is allowed to have like a cheat day every once in a while. Well, she may be able to have a cheat day, and actually I'm gonna take those cheat days away. It could have just been because I had a much bigger cheat day on Father's Day. That she was quite gassy the next day, but she wasn't complaining about it. But I felt exhausted. A while back, some of you may have remembered that I mentioned possibly cutting out gluten to see if it made me not tired, because I felt like I required so much sleep to not be exhausted, even though I was getting 8+ hours a night. And I didn't understand why, and I had heard that gluten could cause it, but I never ended up cutting it out. In the time that I had cut it out with Airily, I didn't even realize that I had felt so much more rested. And the next day, so Monday yesterday, after eating a ton of gluten on Father's Day, I was just exhausted, so tired. I actually had to take a nap when the girls were napping, and I had stomach aches too all day, and I was just like, this isn't worth it. So I may end up keeping gluten out completely, because I may be like actually intolerant to it and didn't even like realize it. And I really don't think it'll be that hard, because one, I've been doing it. It really hasn't been as terrible as I thought. It's only been kind of hard on the weekends when like we go over to Ryan's parents or other people's houses and they're having gluten and stuff. But Ryan and I also have made the decision, which we haven't told you guys yet actually. We've actually made, are you smiling? Yeah, we've actually made quite a big decision to do a complete overhaul on our eating. And we've decided that, and we've been doing this already, that with every grocery shopping trip now, we're not really buying any processed foods. There are like very few things that we are buying still. Like I'm still gonna be getting Revlon her gluten-free chicken nuggets. And then also that like protein pasta. We're just being very careful not pick things with like a ton of preservatives to make sure they're organic or as natural as possible. But like for us, like we're done doing like the processed snack foods. All of those things we're not doing anymore. Ryan and I have actually been saying for years, and I mean years, that we've wanted to get into shape. For a short while, we were eating super healthy together and working out when we were dating. But you may be able to tell, I don't really know. I'm actually 40 pounds overweight. I should weigh about 120, 130, and I weigh 170. So I have weight I need to lose. Some of you guys may not know that Ryan actually used to be pretty overweight. He just wants to get his eating habits back under control because he doesn't want to go back to that way. And he has started gaining some weight, and I'm just like repeating what he says. I personally think he looks fine. but the scale does agree with him, so he's not like losing weight he doesn't need to lose, if that makes sense. But anyways, we just really, I don't even want to focus on the number, and I talked about this on my channel. What? You're not getting a wipe? No. I actually talked about this on my channel. I just want to look in the mirror and feel happy with my body. That's the biggest thing. And that's what Ryan wants too. But in order to do that, you know, we can't just sit here and eat processed crappy foods all day and snack on chips and salsa every night and expect to see that one day. We have to do something. I think it's been a mixture of like seeing our friends make the change, like Randy and Anna. A lot of you guys have been around a while, have heard us talk about Randy and Anna. They're good friends of ours. They've made a complete overhaul in their health lifestyle, and they're doing awesome. It's just kind of been one of a couple of the final pushes towards our decision to make a change. And so we are not buying soda anymore. We're just kind of trying to work through what we have in our house right now, because we're not rich. We don't have the money to just throw out all of our processed foods that we have in the house right now and then start over. So we are finishing what we have in the house. We just have now decided that anything that new comes in, we are not going to be buying any processed stuff. But we are making sure that we are not like health nuts. We're not having cheat days. We're not like having assigned cheat days. That was a real, I think that was my downfall in healthy eating. Because I would have like my cheat day and then the next day I'd just continue eating whatever I wanted. But like if we have a special occasion or something like that, we're not gonna stop ourselves from treating ourselves. Like if we're gonna go to Olive Garden, we can get something to eat, but we're not gonna feel ashamed about it because we know that the majority of our lifestyle is going to be very healthy. Hopefully we can stick to it this time. Wish us luck, guys. Wish us luck. Did you get stuck? Yeah? All right, well you don't pull these things out, miss. Oh, somebody's so happy. Are you so happy looking at the camera? Yeah. That's so nice. You give such nice kisses, Rev. You wanna show the Flutter fam what word you've learned to read? If you guys have been around for any amount of time, then you know that Rev's favorite book is Elmer. And in her Elmer book, there's a page where you turn it and you say, I'm gonna spell it for you guys so you don't think like I'm cheating or whatever. And in that book, there's a page that says B-O-O in really big letters. And so she now knows that page. Like when you turn to it, she just says it. And so out of curiosity last night, was it last night I think, I had Ryan write that on a different piece of paper to see if she would understand it being somewhere else. Now the one in the book for some reason is three O's. I don't know why. And so when we showed her what Ryan drew, this right here, she didn't really realize what it was, but then like I told her what it said and then she was saying it. She woke up this morning and ran to the piece of paper and said it, so she remembered what it said. But today I showed her, I typed it on the computer, and looking at it initially she didn't understand, but then I showed her that piece of paper and then she saw the piece of paper and then looked at the screen and then she realized that they said the same thing and then she said what it said. So I'm gonna see if she does it again, but we'll see. Hey Rev, come here. What does that say?
Blue.
Well, what does that say?
Blue.
Yeah, do they both say that?
Yeah.
What does that say, Rev?
Boop boop.
Boop boop? Yeah. Yeah, all right. She really just wants that apparently, so. But she's understanding like seeing things, seeing word, like this word in different, written in different ways. And so I was wondering if maybe I should get like some short, like easy word flashcards or something to teach her more and see if she catches on. Cause she has like the memory. Like I said, she didn't know what this said last night, but then I told her and when she picked it up this morning, I didn't even have to say anything. She just picked it up and she read it. But I don't know. I don't know if that's normal or what. And I might though see if like she's interested in flashcards. I was planning on doing the teach your child to read because I've been figuring out curriculum and stuff for certain aspects of homeschooling. And I was gonna do the teach your child to read in 100 lessons. Cause that one's gotten like really good reviews and I've heard a lot of great things from people about it. So I was gonna do that with her. But like if she's showing interest already, then I might like introduce some flashcards and get some phonics flashcards as well. And see if she is interested in them because the 100 lessons ones won't work for her age. So at least not that I don't think it will. But anyways, I thought it was interesting, so I thought I'd share it with you guys.
Hi.
You wanna smile?
Look.
What's that say?
Boo.
Does it say boo?
I'm home from work. Been home for a little while. After work, I had to go pick up the car. A Chick-fil-A near us.
What's wrong? Do you want to go see the animals? Yeah?
So as I was trying to say, a Chick-fil-A near us is having, I guess, like a barnyard bash, I think is what it's called. And apparently they're gonna have like a little petting zoo in the parking lot. So, Rev and I are gonna go take a look. Are you ready, Rev?
We're here. Rev. Oh, yeah. Ready? No? Is that scary? That's scary? Yeah, this is Nana's favorite animal. Oh, Rev, look, the pig. The pig's getting ya.
I remember, guys.
What is it? Grab it. Pick it up. Oh, you don't like that? Oh, yep, you got it. Here, let's squeeze it out. Yeah, good job.
So, we had fun there. I bet we've been home for a while, but we didn't spend a ton of time there. It was difficult, as I'm sure you guys saw, to get footage of Rev with the animals when only I was there, but that's okay. Ariana needed a break, huh?
I did. Do you need a potty?
Yeah. You need a potty?
Yeah. She was very difficult today. She was like terrible twos in full force. Like telling her not to do something and she'd smile and go do it, screaming at the top of her lungs. I put her in her crib in the timeout and she peed in her crib to spite me. Literally, she did it on purpose because she had just gone to the bathroom.
Well.
Because she was kicking her sister too. She kept kicking Airly in the face or kicking me. Hitting.
Rev. That is not very nice.
She was
of you.
Not nice today. Were you?
Can you give mommy hugs and kisses? So, we are sitting here on the kitchen floor.
We are.
And we just opened some letters that were at the P.O. box.
P.S. We did order a new P.O. box, but we still have to go to the
post office?
Yes, we still have to go to the post office to get our number, so like sometime this week we should have it. But like I said, we'll name like the blog new P.O. box or something like that, so you guys that are looking for that address will be able to easily find it.
Yes.
We got three letters, and they were from Rebecca Malaya. I hope I'm saying that right. Oh. I think I am Malaya. And then from Meg. And so Meg's letter, if you guys have been around a long time, then you'll remember us opening one of Meg's letters and we were laughing hysterically over it. she lives in Australia, and so she just written us to update us because we hadn't actually heard from her since that letter, and so she's updating us just on what's been going on. She's been going to school for veterinary science, right? That's what she said. And so Meg, it was really good to hear from you again, and we did laugh.
Well, thank you for sending that letter, Meg. We appreciate it.
Yes, and the next letter was from Rebecca, and she had asked a few questions. I will try and address a few of them. Lighthearted questions. Yes, you were asking if we remembered Altoid Sours. He doesn't. I remember them, but I don't remember the flavors because you had asked like what my favorite flavor was. And then you had kind of told us your life story that's been going on with you, and you had asked my
professional opinion.
On service dogs and whether I thought you should get one. That's a decision that you definitely have to make for yourself. Obviously also speaking with like your doctor and your parents too. Do you qualify for one? Because you asked me that. From what I can see, yes. As long as you have like you're diagnosed with like panic attack disorder or generalized anxiety, then legally, yes, you should be able to have a service dog, but the dog just has to have trained tasks to mitigate your disability. So to answer like legally, yes, you should be able to get a service dog. Emotionally, whether you want to take on the responsibility of a service dog, that's definitely something you have to really think about, because it becomes a responsibility of bringing a dog everywhere with you. Some people think that it's all fun and games to bring a dog everywhere with them, and it's not always. You know, there was times where it's like, I wish I could just be normal and not have to bring a service dog with me. So it's just something that definitely you have to make a decision for yourself. But legally, yes, you should qualify for a service dog. And then the last letter was from Malaya. Really hope I'm saying your name right. You have a very beautiful name, even if I'm getting it wrong, just the spelling, because I really like your nicknames. She told us all about her kind of backstory and what had been going on with her. Mm-hmm. And she just told us a little bit about her, and so we just wanted to say thank you for your letter. And I know you had mentioned also thinking about getting a service dog as well, and I'm just gonna say the same thing that I said to Rebecca. It's something you have to decide if it's what's right for you, and I think you know that because that's kind of what you were trying to internalize, think about whether it was something you wanted to take on or not. I know you said that certain people in your life had said that you didn't deserve a service dog, and I don't know why they're viewing it in that way. That's unfortunate that they're viewing it that way. It shouldn't be looked at whether you deserve a service dog. It's whether you need one and you think that it would help you. Mm-hmm. So again, the same advice that I gave to Rebecca. You even said that you knew that it was something that could be overcome. And so maybe you're already past the stage of needing a service dog and you just kind of got to buckle down and push through. But whatever the answer may be for you, you'll have to just figure out and kind of think about it really long and hard, because like I said, it's a responsibility taking on a service dog. Mm-hmm. It's a blessing, but it's a responsibility. So
just like kids.
Yeah, it is. And we talked about that when people constantly asked us if we were nervous about having kids when I was pregnant with Revelin. And we said we weren't really because in a way
we already had one
in that like we were used to not being able to do everything that people could with kids, because you know if we went to Six Flags we had to bring more people with us because somebody had to stay with the service dog. Mm-hmm. we were used to having to pack food for somebody else when we left the house. Obviously it's blown to a bigger proportion with children, but like we were used to that kind of lifestyle already. Mm-hmm. But anyways, thank you all three of you for your
lives. Yes, thank you very much.
A lot to us. And we have one package to open from fellow YouTube friends right here. And this is from the Maltby Bunch.
The Maltby.
Yes, they're good friends of ours.
Bum bada bum bada bum bum bum. Yep, Lena. We did see this one.
Oh, he probably smells the puppies.
Oh yeah, you smell the dogs and cats, huh? Oh goodness.
Oh, a stroller blanket. I've actually like eyed these. I'm sure that most of the shopping was done by Sam.
Probably. I don't think Ryan went to the store.
So I'm super excited about this.
Ooh, 10 little rubber. That's for me.
I think so. Is this by like the same person that did Brown Bear, Brown Bear? That's like the same.
Yeah, it looks like it is the same. Yep.
Think?
Ooh.
Ooh, plan toys. I was just looking at their stuff on Amazon, I think.
Racing bunnies. Daisy, why you spasm?
That's cute.
That's funny.
Thank you very much, Sam and Ryan.
And if you want to see them, we will put a link to their channel in the description below down here. So go check them out. They're super fun. They've got two kids. I think they're 2 and 4.
Yep.
Audrey and Brayden.
They're getting ready for a move soon.
Yes, they're going to be moving.
Becca, Becca, Becca.
So we're going to end the vlog now. Yesterday's question of the day was, what's the most expensive thing you've had to pay to fix? The car. Today's question of the day is going to be from Rebecca.
And she asks, what is your favorite holiday to decorate for?
Ooh, that's a good one. Mm-hmm. So let us know in the comments down below. Hit that thumbs up if you enjoyed the video. Hit that subscribe button if you're new, and as always,
your wonderful face of tomorrow.
Bye, guys.
Me and my mother are here with a cranky little child. Here's a little bit cranky. We're doing round 2 of nursery bedding. My wonderful mother is going to be doing Airly's nursery bedding, like she did Revlon. So I'll give you guys a sneak peek at what we have so far. This is our current pick. There is this yellow, which it's not coming up on camera how it really is, and this white.